everybody. I'm Allie, Assistant Fitness Director at the Harry and Rose Sampson Family at ACC. Thank you for joining me today. Today I'm going to be doing a 30-minute burn HIIT class for you. It's going to be all body weight, so all you should need is a mat if you've got one, definitely some water, and you're probably going to want a towel because you're going to get a little sweaty. If you've got a fitness tracker, go ahead and get it started. I'm gonna see if I've got anybody on here just to make sure you can hear me. If you're on, go ahead and give me a thumbs up or make a comment below just to make sure that my screen is the right way and that sound is coming through. Let's see here. Never mind, maybe we'll keep it that way. So I'll give it a couple more seconds here just to make sure every audio and video is working. I'm gonna get my timer set up here. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with our warm-up. Again, thank you for joining me for this 30-minute burn HIIT class. We're gonna circle the arms forward. Got a couple comments coming in, making sure everything's working. All right, we're good to go. We'll take the arms backwards. So we'll open up those shoulders. Feel a nice stretch in the back and in the chest. Let's crisscross the arms open and close. Stretch through the chest. Squeeze those shoulder blades together in the back. So I've got a fun workout for you today. All different intervals of varying lengths. We're going to have some where the movement is for 20 seconds, some where it's 30 or 40 seconds. Let's step into a side lunge. Big step out to the side. Reach the hips back. Toes are pointed forward, taking the weight over to the other side. Feel a nice stretch on the inner thigh. We'll do a couple more each way. And then let's fold forward, reach for our mat. Feel a nice stretch on those hamstrings. And we'll slowly roll it up here, roll the shoulders back. We're gonna go into a toe touch. So just lift to a height that's comfortable for you, keeping a slight bend in your knee. One more each leg, and rest. Take the feet just outside of the hips. We're gonna do a shallow body weight squat. So hips go back, heels stay on the floor. Go to your working level. This is still the warm-up. We've got plenty of time to take those squats a little bit lower. Last one, and then let's go to a high knee or a march. So still for today, I'm going to be offering some lower impact modifications. I'm still not jumping, but if you guys at home want to take it up a notch and add a jump or take the intensity level up a little bit higher, I'll be giving you those options. I will be doing the lower level for those of you who need it. So pick those knees up a little bit higher, pump those arms a little bit faster. Three, two, one, and rest. All right, make sure your towel and water are nearby. We're gonna get rolling. So the first part to kick off this workout is a 2-minute drill. You're gonna have three exercises. You're gonna do as many rounds as you can. So your first one, jump jumping jacks. You're gonna do 10 jumping jacks, traditional or this modified version. Then you're gonna go into 5 squats. So pretty basic, simple squat. And then we've got inchworm push-ups. So you're gonna start on the end of your mat or your towel, whatever you're using, you're gonna walk the hands out into a plank, push up, travel back. You've got 2 of those, and you can also put your knees down for the push-up. So, get yourself ready. We've got jumping jacks first. So you've got 10 jumping jacks, 5 squats, 2 inchworm push-ups. We're gonna get ready. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 10 jumping jacks. Now you're going at your own pace here. See if you can stick up with me. Great. If you're going faster, awesome. If you're a little bit slower, that's okay too. Keep going at your pace. 5 squats when you're ready. Good, then we've got that inchworm push-up. You're walking out so the hands are under the shoulders. Push up, travel back. One more. And walk back. No break in between. We're right back at the top. Five squats. See if you can get a little bit lower than you did in that warm up. Good. Inchworm push-ups. Belly button to spine here as you go into that plank. We've got just under 50 seconds left. See what you can do. Push yourself. Good. Squats. Drive up through those heels. Squeeze the glutes at the top. Keep rolling through. Don't quit here. 15 seconds. See if you can get through whatever exercise you might be on. Rest. Nice job. So, from here, we're switching it up. Grab some water, grab a towel. I'll explain what's coming up next. From here, we've got a 20-10 style Tabata. So you're gonna have 2 exercises, 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest. We're gonna go groups of 2. So, your first exercise is a shuffle burpee. So you can shuffle fast, a little bit more of a jog, or step, okay? That's your first move. Take 3 or 4 shuffles to each side, whatever feels natural. And then from there, we're gonna take it down to our mat. We're gonna have seated twists. So we'll twist side to side. That shuffle burpee is first. So 20 seconds of work. Sink down into a squat. Stay low in those legs. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Side shuffle, burpee. You can hop those feet back or step the feet back. Take the impact out, whatever works best for you, but stay low in those legs. Rest. All right, we've got a quick 10-second break. Catch your breath, timer's gonna start. Here we go, stay low, same exercise. quick seat to your mat. We've got seated twists. So this is what it looks like from the other way. Here we go, heels into the floor, back stays flat. Big twist to each side, keeping those shoulders relaxed. Rest. We've got one more. So you've got some options here. Heels can be down or lift them off the floor. This is your workout. You pick where you're at today. Maybe you lift them for the last few seconds. Rest. All right, quick transition. We are back to that shuffle burpee. We're at the halfway point here. Sink low. Here we go. If you're thinking, Ellie, this isn't enough, add a push-up onto your burpee. Rest. You've only got one more round of those. Make it your best. Then we'll take a break from the burpees for a little bit, but then they're gonna come back. This is your last round. Give it everything you've got. Rest. Catch your breath. Head down to your mat. Twists. Three, two, go. Core is strong. Full twist to each side. Whew. Rest. We've got one more, and then I'm gonna mix it up again. We'll have a little bit different timing. Here we go. Twist, twist. Twist. Last 10 seconds. See if you can lift your feet. Hold those feet off the floor. Rest. All right. Well-deserved break here. From here, we're going to go into a 30-second move with a 10-second rest. So the exercise is getting a little bit longer in duration, same rest. So we've got three exercises. We're going to focus on the lower body a little bit. Our first one, traditional lunge. I'll throw out some add-ons as we go through. From here, skaters, you can stay low and step side to side, or stay low, leap side to side. Your choice, wherever you're at. And then your last one, lunge jumps. You can do the jump or do a quick tap back to take out that high impact. All right, we've got 30 seconds. We're only doing this one time through. So, first one, traditional lunge in three, two, one. Lunge it back and up. Chest stays tall. Drive up through that front heel. Press that knee out to the side just a little bit. Want to add on? Drive through that knee. Add some balance and a little bit more core. Rest. All right, make sure you have some space. Skaters are next. 30 seconds. Stay back. Keep going. We've only got 10 seconds. Make it count. Rest. All right. Lunge jumps. You can do the jump or stick with the tap back. Here we go. Either way, see how low you can take that lunge. Belly button to spine. Keep going. You are over halfway. Strong legs. Rest. All right, quick break. Grab some water. Grab your towel if you need it. From here, we've got three exercises, 45 seconds each, with a 15 second rest. So you're getting a little bit longer break here. So we've got two of these. Our first exercise is gonna be a squat with a calf raise. So you're gonna sink down, come up to the toes. Sink down, come up to the toes. From there, we're going into a plank. You can be on your hands or your forearms. So you're just gonna hold there. Then we'll rest, and we're going into a plank with a downward dog and a toe touch. So you're piking up through the hips and reaching for the toes on the opposite side. All right, first one, squat with a calf raise. I don't know about you guys, but I am sweaty, so make sure you keep drinking water. All right, squat with a calf raise. In 3, 2, 1, sink down, come up. You can add a reach, add a little bit extra with those arms. If not, stay here. Sink down, come up to the toes. Squeeze through the glutes at the top. It's gonna help with your balance. See how low we can get. See if you can do two more. Rest. All right, we're heading to the mat. Find the plank position that works best for you. We're just holding. You can be here, come on up. Or take it down to your forearms. Belly button to spine, shoulders over elbows or wrists. Squeeze through the back body. Little tuck of that pelvis. Keep holding. You are down to 10 seconds. Rest. Roll out those shoulders. We've got plank to downward dog next. So I'm gonna start on my hands. Walk my feet out. Here we go. Pike up, reach. Come down, pike So from here, carefully stand on up. Your first move is a lunge, twist, twist. Come back to center. Lunge. Hold your lunge, twist, twist. Come back to center. From there, we're going to the mat. Traditional crunches. So, lie back, hands behind your head, crunch up and down. From here, we've got bridges. So, both feet on the floor, press through the heels, lift the hips, and lower down. Lift and lower. All right, we will get started with that lunge and a twist. So, whichever leg you want to start on, we're going to lunge it back, twist to each side. In 3, 2, 1. Lunge it back, twist, twist. Step forward. Lunge, twist, twist. Come forward. Keep alternating legs. Try to press those hips forward a little bit when you're in that lunge. Twist, twist. Chest stays up tall. Rest. Arms go to your sides. We've got bridges next. So both feet on the floor. You're going to press up from the heels. Here we go. Lift and lower. Squeeze through those glutes at the top. Try to lift the hips back up before they tap the mat. Drive up through those heels. See if you can hold for a second, then lower down. Got a few more. Rest. Carefully come on up. We're in the home stretch. We've got three more intervals and then a bonus round at the end for a little fun. So our first one, 40 seconds. We're back to that plank position. You can be on your hands or your forearms. We're doing a plank with a rotating hip drop. So you're going to come up into that plank, rotate one hip down, come back to center, rotate the other hip. So you're just going side to side with those hips. From there, mountain climbers. You're going to be in that plank, driving those knees in towards your chest. After that, coming back onto our back, feet up in the air, ready for that plank with a hip drop. We've got 40 seconds of work, followed by a little bit longer rest. So, plank with the hip dip in 3, 2, 1. Come on up, find your plank, add in that rotation. So you're just lowering that hip towards the floor. If you need to, take those feet a little bit wider. It'll help with your balance and keeping those hips down. Last few seconds. See if you can fully extend. We're going to lower and lift. We're here for 20 seconds. Keep that lower back pushed into your mat. If needed, go single leg. And rest. Pull the knees in. Stretch out the lower back. We are on to our last 40, 30, 20. From here, bridges are first. 2 feet, just like we did before, for 40 seconds. Then we're going 30 seconds, alternating a single leg bridge. For 20 seconds, we're gonna do a frog bridge. So your feet are gonna, bottoms of your feet are gonna be together, knees fall out to the side, and lift and lower, lift and lower. So for that frog bridge, your feet are kind of making a diamond shape. So the bottom of your feet are together like this. But let's start with that traditional bridge. Feet are parallel. Go ahead and lie back. 3, 2, 1, and lift and lower. Same as we did before. Driving through those heels. Squeeze at the top. Good. See if you can lift to the tips of those shoulder blades. Rest. Take one leg over the other. Pull it in. Hold for a few seconds. Then switch. And place both feet on the floor. We've got alternating bridges. So lift and lower, switch legs. So we're driving up through one leg at a time, adding a little bit of a challenge here. Rest. All right, that frog bridge, 20 seconds. So knees are out to the sides. Our feet are in that diamond shape. Get ready. Here we go, lift and lower. So we're feeling this bridge in a little bit different place than we did the ones before. This is a little bit more inner glutes here. And rest. Carefully come on up. Catch your breath. I've got a bonus round for you. So, little bit of a challenge to do at the end. It's going to be 20 seconds of movement. I want you to see how many burpees you can get in 20 seconds. Once you're done, comment below with how many you got in. When we do this 30-minute burn HIIT again, if you join us, it's going to be the same challenge. I want to see if you can beat what you did with me today. So if you do these burpees, however many you get in 20 seconds, comment below. And then when we do this later in the week, see if you can beat it. See if you can add one or two. All right. Traditional burpee, nothing fancy. You can do the step out or the hop. Get ready. 20 seconds in 3, 2, 1, and go. bet you guys can beat me. Comment below with what you got and join us again on Thursday with Jack. All right, let's get to our well-earned cool down. Take one arm across the chest and hold. Start to slow down that breath in through the nose, out through the mouth, and switch. Other arm comes over. And release. Let's go into a quad stretch. Bend at the knee, bring the foot up behind. Take the other arm out for balance if needed. Release. Bring the other foot up. Same thing. And release. Take one heel into the floor. Pitch the hips back. Drop the chest forward and hold. And then point those toes towards the floor. And come back up. Switch sides, heel into the floor, pitch forward. Toes go into the floor. And come back up. Interlace those fingers. Reach the arms up towards the ceiling. Feel like you're growing taller as you reach the arms up. Lean to the side. And to the other side. Back to center. Release. Interlace those fingers behind you. Reach the arms up. And rest. Nice work today. Thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you guys soon. Have a good one.